I'm Dr. Omojada Awosusi. In this video, I want to share with you 5 qualities of effective communication in higher education. Communication is one of the major differences between the living and the dead. Communication basically is about interaction. It's one of the major means of socialization. Human beings cannot exist without communication. We have to interact one way or the other. Communication can be verbal, it can be non-verbal, it could be oral, it could be written, it could be in diverse ways. But I just want to look at the qualities of what we can call effective communication. Communication is not effective if it doesn't move from one sender to the receiver, and if it gets to the receiver and it's ambiguous, it's not clear, or the man on the other end cannot understand what you are saying, then it's not effective. And if that communication does not achieve the purpose for which it has been transmitted, it's not effective. I want to share 5 qualities. One is correctness. Correctness. Any piece of communication, could it be, is it a report, is it minutes of meeting, is it circular, is it invitation card, is it a letter, is it a memo, whatever it is, there must be the principle of correctness. Facts in the communication must be correct, figures must be correct, dates, time, numbers must be correct. The syntax, the grammar, the spelling, the punctuation, everything in that communication, when one is wrong and is not correct, it creates problem and it is not effective. Number 2, courtesy. The time, the tone, diction, selection of words, the vocabulary, whatever it is that is inputted in that communication medium must be courteous. The sender must be courteous of the receiver. Who is that person in relation to the sender? Is it somebody, is it a higher authority? Is it my boss? Is it going above us? Is it going to government agency? Is it going to the vice chancellor, the chancellor, or the visitor to the university? Or is it going to a royal majesty? So courtesy is very important, because if that aspect is out of it, no matter what the content of that communication medium is, it may be discontinuous. Number 3 is adequacy. The information in any medium must be adequate. Must be adequate. The comprehensiveness of the communication is very important. It has to be comprehensive. All of the information required have to be there. It doesn't have to be verbose, because in actual fact, conciseness, brevity is a major factor in communication. But something can be very brief, a communication can be very brief, but it is important that all the information we need should be contained there. For example, if you are sending a notice of meeting, or you are sending an invitation card, an invite to somebody, and you don't give all of the information, the receiver may not be able to act on it effectively. For example, you give the day of a meeting, you give the date, but you don't give the venue of the meeting, or you don't give the contact details. There will be a problem. When you ask somebody to come on 1st December, and you are not mentioning the day in the week, whether it's Monday, Tuesday, the person may still miss the meeting, because he wakes up to his morning, it's 1st December. But he may wake up and doesn't know that today is 1st December. So there are people like that. You get to the bank, you want to fill in the teller, people ask from others, what's today's date? That kind of person, if you have received a notice of meeting and you don't tell him it's Monday, Tuesday, you just mention the date, you can miss the meeting. You may not remember until the meeting. So the adequacy, comprehensiveness is very important in communication. Number 4, the principle of keys. You need to keep your information, your communication, short and simple. Keep it short and simple. The shorter a message, the greater the possibility that the receiver will be able to consume the information. If it is too long, if it is too voluminous, people may not get the gist of what you are saying. You need to keep your information short and simple. Number 5, which is the final point I want to make, is clarity. Whatever you are sending across, whether it's a letter, it's a memo, it's a circular, is a report, you need to make it, it must be clear. You can do executive summary so that what we are saying, the totality of this document could be 100 pages, you need to make it clear. And usually in the university system, we put a kind of paragraph, what is action required? All said and done, what exactly do you want me to act upon? It's put action required. And you try to remove ambiguities. So we must know who, where is it coming from, where is it going, for what purpose, and what exactly are we talking about? That is clarity. Let me summarize what I've said in this presentation. I was talking about five qualities of effective communication in higher education. I said correctness. What you are saying must be correct. Courtesy. Number three is adequacy. Number four is keep it short and simple. Number five, clarity. If you have listened to me, I want to thank you for watching this video. And I hope you are going to keep all of these 5 points in mind when you want to work on the next communication you are sending across to somebody or to a group of people. Thank you.